Hello guys, my name is Mukanya. I'm a CEO and founder at Jquery. Welcome to Jquery tutorial in 2022. We're going to define Jquery. It's a JavaScript library created by John in 2006. It's based on the concept of write less and do more. It's been designed to simplify Jquery code when accessing or manipulating the HTML. So let's testing. I will go to Jquery website. You just have to tap Jquery. It should be jquery.com. Then once you get on the page, then you just have to go to download tab. Then you can download it or install it on your system, but I prefer to use CDN. So CDN is short for Content Delivery Network. All right. So I'll go for the one for Google and make sure that I make a copy of the one, because those are the version. I will stick with the latest version. Then copy it, and then you paste it on your HTML file. So make sure that you paste it above your script that has a link to your jQuery that it's going to contain a jQuery code. So make sure that you put it above this line, because if the link, the script that is being linked to your file that you're going to provide jQuery code, and then you place it above the library, then imagine, just guess what? Your code will not going to work, and then you're going to be frustrated about it, and then you say, oh, my code is not working. First of all, the first thing when you see that kind of errors, then check if you establish the link correctly. So that's why I prefer to copy it from where it was, from here, from that page. Then I'm not gonna change anything. Then just paste it on my file, and then that's it. Okay. Then let's see what next. Maybe they just close it. There's some few things that I want to mention before we continue. So jQuery has its features. So it's easy to use when manipulating the DOM. And then it has a huge community. The community where you're going to ask questions. And then there's also some guys who keep providing the maintenance. Keep providing maintenance to the library. So if there's some bugs on the library, they're going to fix it. So it's a cross-browser support. So it means that it does support different browsers. You can use it, so you don't have to worry if it's going to be used on, if it's going to support Internet Explorer or other browser. Okay, so it has a lot of plugins. One of the plugins, it will be like Ajax. So Ajax, we're going to talk about it once we get to advanced to web development. So it simplifies JavaScript and allow us to provide the animations. So how to use it? So we can install it locally or download it locally, or we can make use of CDN. So with jQuery selector, on the previous version, we were using jQuery as a word, and then you have to tap jQuery so that you can provide other code. So before everything, so that's why they replaced jQuery keyword with $ to simplify the code. So this one to allow us to access a particular query, or element. And then you can, the selector will be the target. So let's say, for instance, I want to display a test on the paragraph, then the target will be the paragraph. Okay, so that's why we refer to it in jQuery as a selector. Then after the selector, we have action. So the most important that you have to know that is before you can provide your jQuery, make sure that it's been wrapped inside of a document that's ready. So because if you don't have it, and then if your jQuery was not loaded on the browser, then guess what? Your code will not going to work. Okay, so I'm going to show you a basic code that I have. Okay, let me first provide with tab jQuery $ parentheses. Then we specify document dot ready, and then between the parentheses we need to pass a function. Yeah, there we say function. So in advance, we're going to make use of an error function. But since we stay on the intro, I still have to keep things simple. Okay. Then we type function. Then after that is done, then we can use again $ the target, which would be the paragraph, and then our action, which would be test. Because we just want to display a test on our paragraph. So we can just say hello world. And then it does it. Okay, then just refresh our page and voila. So let's see what next. So let's see. I'm going to press this one at the bottom. So we have, so the test is one of the selector methods. Okay, so let's see what I'm going to okay, I'm going to use this example, this method. Okay, let's see. Let's apply maybe a background color on our paragraph. Then we say $ p dot css. Then we need to specify the attributes. So the key, it will be, I believe it will be background. Background color, and then comma. Let's specify maybe gray. Let's see. Okay, here we go. And then if you want to change the text from black to green, then you can just the test color, then that would be color, then we specify test, then I will refresh it, and here we go. I'm going to zoom in, and there we go. Let's see other method that we can use. So before, all right. So before it's going to insert a specific content before the selector element or before the selected element. So right here we just have before the paragraph there's nothing. Let me try to, or before our hello world, or on top of, if I can put it in simple word, before or on top of hello world, there's nothing, yeah? So let's try to see if we can place something else in there using before. And then we say, p, so before, let me try and say, which one would be? Test. So let's see. I'm going to go to inspect and go to elements. So we see that it was just a test. So if we want to wrap it inside of a particular element, let's see what will it be. So if I put maybe h2, then plus h2, see what will be the result. And then I'm just going to refresh it. Okay, set. Then go to body, then see that it's updated to H2. All right. So as for your homework, so you can continue with other jQuery methods. So our next video is going to be we're going to focus on the jQuery event. Okay, thank you guys. Please subscribe, share, and like the video. Bye.